Good morning students, today we are going to start with a new chapter of history, that is ruling the countryside. Now in this chapter, after the company becomes Diwan, there were certain duties that has to be fulfilled by the company. First, as the Diwan, they become the chief financial administrator of the territory under its control. Administer the land. Now it had to think of administering the land and organizing its revenue resources. Third, company expenses. This has to be done in a way that could yield enough revenue to meet the growing expenses of the company. A trading company had also to ensure that it could buy the product it needed and sell what it wanted. After the company becomes Diwan, they saw that the revenue of the company was going under the depression. So deep crisis in the Bengal economy was faced. What were the reasons of that deep crisis? First, the artisans were deserting in villages. Soon, it was clear that Bengal economy was facing deep crisis, and one of the reasons artisans were deserting villages since they were being forced to sell their goods to the company at a low prices. They were unable to pay the dues. Peasants were unable to pay the dues that were being demanded from them. Artisanal production was in decline. And agricultural cultivation showed signs of collapse. Then, in 1770, a terrible famine killed 10 million people in Bengal. About one-third of the population was wiped out. After that, the company have to think certain measures so that they can gain some money for the company. And with this thing in mind, they introduced new revenue system. The first revenue system that was introduced by the Britishers, that was permanent settlement. This settlement was introduced by Charles Cornwallis in the year 1793. In this system, Rajas and Talukdars were recognized as Zamindars, means mediators. They were asked to collect rent from the peasants and pay revenue to the company. Now, the amount which is to be paid to the company was fixed and it will not be increased ever in future. They thought introducing this kind of revenue system will going to encourage the zamindars and they will going to improve the agricultural land. This is Charles Cornwallis. Now there were certain problems with this system of permanent settlement. First, zamindars were not investing for the improvement of land. They were dishonest, they just wanted their own profit. Next is revenue which was fixed was too high that the zamindars found it difficult to pay and also lost their zamindari. Now in villages, cultivators found the system extremely oppressive. Their right on land was insecure because any point of time if they are not able to pay the taxes, the lands will be taken from them which they have tilled for generations. To pay the revenue, they took loan from moneylender, which they were not able to pay back. When they failed to pay, they were evicted from their land. After this system, which was a failure, the second system which was introduced by the Britishers was Mahilwari settlement. Now, this settlement was introduced by Holt McKenzie in the year 1822. It was introduced in northwestern provinces of the Bengal Presidency. Most of this area is now in Uttar Pradesh. Now, under this system, the duty was given to the headman to collect the taxes. Under his direction, collectors went from village to village, inspecting the land, measuring the field, and recording the customs and rights of different groups. The estimated revenue of each plot within a village was added up to calculate the revenue that each village, that is Mahal, had to pay. Now this demand was to be revised periodically. In the previous settlement, the revenue was fixed for the year and in this settlement, the revenue will be revised periodically and it will not be permanently fixed. The charge of collecting the revenue and paying it to the company was given to the village headman rather than the zamindar. So in this system, no mediator. This system came to be known as the Mahalwari settlement. This is Holt McKenzie. Now the third system for the improvement of land and for more profit to be gained by the revenue system was introduction of the third settlement, that is Munro system. This system is also known as Royathwari system. In the British territories in the south, there was a similar move away from the idea of permanent settlement. The new system that was devised was came to be known as the Royathwar or Royathwari. It was tried on a small scale by Captain Alexander Reed, and in some of the areas that were taken over by the company after the wars with Tipu Sultan. The other person who introduced this system apart from Captain Alexander Reed was Thomas Munro, and it gradually extended in the areas of south in India. Now this settlement, they argued, had to be made directly with the cultivators, again no mediators, who had tilled the land for generation. Their fields had to be carefully and separately surveyed before the revenue assessment was made. Now Munro thought that the British should act as a paternal father figure protecting the royals under the charge. This, as you can see on the board, there is a difference between Mahalwari system and permanent system. In Mahalwari system, the village headman was supposed to take the revenue. In permanent settlement, Rajas and Talukdars were responsible for collecting the revenue. In Mahalwari system, the revenue was not fixed. In permanent settlement, the revenue was fixed. Now, after that, Britishers wanted to think more to gain more profit from India. So, in path of that, they introduced indigo. As you can see on the board, indigo is a blue dye. Today, nowadays, we have cloths that are made from indigo dye. They are blue in color and it is rich blue in color. So, why this indigo was introduced by the Britishers? It was introduced to increase the profit revenue was not enough from the three revenue system. By the late 18th century, company tried to expand the cultivation of opium and indigo. Opium was not successful, but indigo was very successful. For this, the Britishers persuaded or forced the cultivators to produce other crops like tea, jute, sugarcane, wheat, rice, cotton, etc. Means plantation. One crop, two or three crops at one time. Demand for indigo from India started increasing because of its good quality and it produced a rich blue color dye. But small amount was reaching European market and at a very high price. The demand was more and the production was less. With the rising demand, the company in India looked for ways to expand the areas under cultivation. As the indigo trade grew, commercial agents and officials of the company began investing in indigo production. Attracted by the prospect of high profit, numerous Scotsmen and Englishmen came to India and became planters. Two systems of indigo cultivation. First, niche means own, and other one was royal. Now in niche cultivation, in this system the planters produce indigo in land that they directly own or control, means doing cultivation in their own land. Either they bought the land or rented and produced indigo by direct employing hired laborers. In royal system, the planters forced the royal to sign a contract. Now this planters here, it could be Britishers also, it could be Scotsmen also, it could be Indians also. Indians means the Britishers have given some contract to the Indians so that they can grow indigo for the Britishers. So here what the planters used to do is that they used to force the headmen to sign a contract or an agreement which is known as satta. In this they got the cash advances and also provided with seeds and money to prepare soil, etc. Now after the introduction of these two systems, and after the need for growing indigo, there were a lot of problems in the cultivation also. Now, what were the problems with the niche cultivation is that indigo could only be cultivated on fertile lands, but these areas were densely populated and hence only small plots could be acquired. This made it difficult to expand the area under niche cultivation. The second problem, they attempted to lease in the land around the indigo factory. While doing so, they evicted the peasants, which also created a major problem from the area. Peasants' eviction always created conflict and tension in the area. Third, a large plantation required a large number of workers. Work at indigo plantation coincided with the time when peasants were busy with rice cultivation. Hence, mobilizing the labor for indigo cultivation was a difficult task. They were not ready to work under indigo cultivation because at the same point of time there was rice cultivation, which was more important to them. Because indigo cultivation was creating problems, they were not being profited by anything, and the hard labor they have to give. Now, in this chapter, we have studied that how company became Diwan. We have studied the three indigo system, the three revenue system. We also studied about the indigo system, the two methods of cultivation, and then what were the problems associated with the cultivation. Now, you all have to do these questions at home. Thank you.